going to do is we're going to talk about the difference between the arithmetic scale chart and the logarithmic scale chart. So the first one that we're going to look at is the logarithmic scale. This is the semi-log chart. In many cases, it's called a percentage chart. And the reason is because you can see here on the y-axis, the larger you see the space, the larger the percentage changes. So in this case, from 2 to 3, you're looking at a 50% move. Notice how it's a much wider space than something between 26 and 30. So here we are looking at shares of triple D, 3D systems from 2007 to 2013 in a beautiful uptrend. Now we're looking at the exact same chart, but on an arithmetic scale chart. So this is a linear chart where you can see how on the y-axis, the difference between 2 and 4 is the same as it is from 40 and 42, although the percentages are much different. So here from 2 to 4, you're looking at a 100% change. And up here from 40 to 44, you're looking at a 10% change. But look at the difference. They're the exact same thing. So when you look at an arithmetic scale chart that the price changes are this dramatic, down here below, you can't even see the price changes. So by looking at the logarithmic scale, you could really see the volatility that took place in 2009, while in the linear chart, you simply cannot. So I think it's important to use logarithmic scale charts if you're looking at a chart where there is a dramatic change in price, like there is in 3D systems from 2007 until 2008, 2009, 2013. But if you're also looking at a long-term chart, 30-year, 50-year, 80-year chart, by definition, you're going to have huge price swings, so you definitely want to be using a logarithmic scale chart. I would argue that the one point, the one group that doesn't necessarily need to focus on log charts are day traders. So if you're a day trader, you could stick with your arithmetic scale, that linear chart, and I think you'll be fine.